Good afternoon and welcome. My name is May Sheeby Reardon. I'm the executive director of the Missouri Lottery, and I'm at the luckiest Coldwell Banker Premier Group office ever. We're so delighted not to only hand out one check here, but we have lots of winners here, and we're going to let them introduce themselves as well. Let's go ahead and get that started, and tell us when did you win?
My name is Kim DeLapp, and I won about a year ago, and it was on a scratch-off, $100,000.
That's awesome. Let's hear it for $100,000. And I handed your check out.
Yes, you did. Jamie Bone and I won $1 million last year.
What do you have? Yay! Awesome. And they both still have money left. Now, and they tell me they bought these tickets because they know that the money does go to education here in Missouri, elementary, secondary, and higher education. So definitely, you all helped out education here in the state of Missouri. Yay! So today, I am very pleased to present a $3.8 million check. Oh, help me hold that. It's heavy. To Jenifer, who also works here, and her partner Lee. We're glad to have you both here. And we'd like to know a little bit about yourselves and about what you play often, you said. And
you
played the lotto, and you did Quick Pick, right?
I did Quick Pick, yes. I didn't even look at the numbers, and it was just random. So I usually play Powerball with a Power Play and Show Me Cash and a lotto.
Oh, that's awesome. Those are all great products that we offer. Mm-hmm. So tell us about how you found out when you won.
I didn't even know how much the lotto was, and I didn't even know what numbers were on there. Usually I look at them and I go, oh, that's not a winner. It doesn't have my number 7 in it. And it didn't have my number 7, but I didn't even look. I just went into Dierbergs and stuck it under the little scanner. Yeah, and proceeded to shake and freak out.
Did you ask if boys come over and make sure you're okay?
Yeah, and they're like, what's wrong? And I said, this thing says, what, $3.8 million? And they're like, no. And I'm like, here, check it. And so they checked it. And
that's great. That was that. Yeah. That's great. Now, what do you hope to do with the money?
I'm going to actually go back to school full-time for master's in social work, and then we're going to be putting it away for retirement and helping our church and doing some things.
And a little travel, right,
Lee?
Tell me where you like to go.
First trip is to California, resorts, to just kind of decompress. Mm-hmm. And, you know, we've talked about eventually ending up in Florida and not exactly knowing where exactly, but we're excited about being blessed with this gift.
That's fantastic. And you're going to continue to work, is that right, here at Coldwell Banker?
Yep.
Yes.
Yay.
Yay. Yay. Yay. Now, is that 5 days a week, 7 days a week, or are you just going to work like one day a week?
Well, yeah. We'll see what happens.
Exactly. Keep an eye on her. Well, good. Any other thoughts about how you won or why you won? I heard you talking a little bit about...
Yeah, we won. Last year, we lost Lee's father and my father-in-law, and every day... We would go to where he was. We were taking care of him, and he would have to have a lottery ticket, and we couldn't get in his apartment without a lottery ticket, a box of Krispy Kreme donuts, and a pack of cigarettes.
And
so he was 85 years old. So I'm not saying anything about the way health is these days, right? So he always wanted to win, and I heard him that day.
Oh, that's great. So
he really was our blessing.
Now, did you believe Jenifer when she first called you?
Well, actually, I was at church, and she came back to church. I was teaching a class, and I saw her outside the door of my class, and I thought something was really bad wrong. You know, that's where your mind goes.
Yeah.
And she looked like she had seen a ghost, and she was with one of our pastors. And we went in, and she was shaking like a leaf, dropped the tickets on the ground, and she was saying we won $3.8 million.
And you knew she wasn't lying because we're a church.
Yeah, right?
It's the one place
I am good. Got down on the floor, and our pastor pulled it up on the internet and on her phone, and we double-checked the numbers, and then we were jumping up and down, and then I said, we just have to pray. And so we got on our knees and just prayed.
That's exciting. Did you hear what she said? She goes, that's the one place I don't lie.
Right.
I don't.